Hello friends, Dr. Sangeeta with you for another lecture on the child psychology. That is, today's topic is Erikson's psychosocial theory. Now, the previous video we have covered one more psychodynamic theory, which was our Sigmund Freud psychosexual theory. Now, Freud focused more on the basic needs and the biological forces, that is the sexual forces. And Erikson, on the other hand, he was actually a fan of Freud. And along with Freud's daughter, he came up with a psychosocial theory. Now, psychosocial theory of the Erik H. Erikson focuses on the environmental factor, which were missing on the Freud's theory. So let's get started with the mnemonics and Erik Erikson psychosocial theory. Erikson concentrated on the child development when the child is conscious. Unlike the Freud's theory, which was based on the sexual aspect more, now the Erikson's theory is based on the environmental factor. Erikson theory is based on the social factor. Now the lifespan, the entire lifespan of life cycle from the intimacy to the childhood, Erikson described in like 8 stages, which are marked by the internal crisis. There is a psychological crisis, there is a psychosocial crisis occurring at every stage of our life, which is based on the positive response and the negative response, which he described as the crisis. Now, based on that, Erikson described 8 stages of the life. These are trust versus mistrust, autonomy versus shame and doubt, initiative versus guilt, industry versus inferiority, identity versus role confusion, intimacy versus isolation, generativity versus stagnation, and ego integrity versus despair. Now, these stages are happening at every stage of our life, starting from infancy till the older adult. So, infancy, we have trust versus mistrust. Toddler, we have autonomy versus shame and doubt. We'll be studying each stage in detail now. Now, I have a mnemonic for you. If you want to memorize these stages in one shot, then there is a true mistress ki hope, auto me sham ko initiate hui, par guilt jo industry me thi, wo inferiority le aai identity me, aur apne role ko lekar confuse hui intimacy aur isolation ke baad bhi generativity aur stagnation me integrity aur despair hui. Now, true mistress ki hope sham ko auto mein initiate hui, par guilt jo industry mein thi, inferiority le aai, identity mein role ko lekar confuse hui thi, intimacy aur isolation ke baad bhi, generativity aur stagnation mein integrity aur despair hui. Now, these all are the 8 stages of Erikson, which he has described, coming to the first stage, which is the trust versus mistress. This happens during infancy. Now, he is just on food and he is just doing potty. Now, infant cannot survive without any help. He cannot do anything on his own. He cannot, infant needs food and he wants somebody to change his diaper. And if an infant is well handled and nurtured and loved, he gets the feeling of security. He gets the feeling of trust with the mother. If you have seen, most of the time, the infants are actually attached more to the mother. Now, if they are not paid attention at early stages of life, if the parents are too busy, or if the baby is handled badly, then there is mistrust which is developed, and the feeling of mistrust and insecurity developed in the child at the infancy stage. Now, if any necessary dental treatment is to be provided at this stage, now it should be done when the parent is present. The parent holding the child, it should be present when the parent, it should be done when the parent is holding the child. It builds the trust. It builds a level of trust in the child, in the adolescent. And at this stage, if the parents are separated, if the child is treated all alone, then because of the separation, anxiety develops in the child. Now, once the child loses the basic trust in the world, it's difficult to get the confidence back and to get the support from the dentist and the staff. Now, coming to the second stage, we have autonomy versus shame. When a 2 to 3 year old toddler, when a child starts walking, Then he start works on the potty training. When the toddler is doing potty by himself, then he gets this feeling. He gets the feeling of autonomy when he can go to potty all by himself. And he gets this feeling of independence and proud. And the willpower that if they are unable to do it, they end up in shame and doubt. Then the child, a 3-year child, when wets the bed, he's ashamed about it. He's guilty about it. And you should give the child some little choices and some independence at this stage in their life. So at this stage, the child takes pleasure doing tasks by himself. And while doing a dental treatment, the dentist must obtain cooperation. He must develop a cooperation from the child, from the toddler. It's himself, and dentist should make him believe that it is the toddler, he wants the treatment. It is his choice that he wants the treatment, not the dentist or the parents. But as well as the parents' presence is essential in the dental clinic, and if the parent is moved away from the child, if the child is moved away from the mother, but still will the retreat to her in a threatening situations, but the presence of the parent is essential in the dental clinic, especially the mother. Now coming to the third stage, we have initiative versus guilt, which is seen in the preschool 4 to 5 years old of the children. The preschools lives in the life of a fantasy. They try to learn things which are happening around, all around them, and they have lot of questions. During 4 to 5 years of age, the child asks lot of questions. They come up with their statements, usually start with a question asking from why and what, and they draw whatever they see around. They actually, if this feeling is restricted, and the restricting their development in the imagination and play school results in them guilty, results a guilty factor in them. He should be encouraged to visit the dentist, and he should be teach it as a adventurous experience. And if the visit fails, then the child can lead to a sense of guilt. Now coming to the fourth stage, we have industry versus inferiority, which is seen in the school children, which is seen at 5 to 12 years of age. Now the school children are more into studies, or they are into arts, or some children are into sports, but they love doing the things they want, and they try to learn culture, they try to learn the social ethics, they try to learn cultural skills. And if a child is doubted, or if a child is mistrusted at this stage, and ashamed of guilt which was there previously in the preschool makes the child defeated at this stage and builds inferiority complex at the school age in their life. Now if cooperation is developed at this stage, and if the child if the dentist make the child understand the need of the treatment and the need to please the dentist or the parents, or if the peer group is supportive, then the desired result can be reinforced by the dentist. There should be positive reinforcement for a dental treatment at this stage. Now coming to the fifth stage, we have identity versus role confusion. Now there is a term which was given by Erikson, which is identity crisis. Identity crisis is usually seen in the adolescents. They start asking questions like, who am I? What do I want from my life? Try to learn their identity at this stage. And if they are better adjusted, sometimes they experience some role confusion because of the pressure from the parents. When they are unable to explore themselves, they experience role confusion. Any orthodontic treatment which is carried out at this stage is actually due to the child's consent. When the child wants the ortho treatment, because at the adolescent age, the parental authority is usually rejected by the adolescents, and they try to impose things. Now coming to the sixth stage, we have intimacy versus isolation. This is actually all about young age. This is about love life. So this is the love life. A successful young adult for the first time experiences love, experiences intimacy, and further on a good marriage and genuine and good friendships. So at this stage, the external appearance, the aesthetic is very important for a young individual, especially to achieve the intimate relationship. Now, the adult usually seek ortho treatment for appearances, but if any alteration of the looks is done, it interferes with the previous established relationship. So the treatment should be explained properly, should be discussed with the young adults. Now coming to the seventh stage, we have generativity versus stagnation, which is all about parenthood or which is all about love. Now the parents, the generation is taking care of the previous generation or the young generation. The eighth generation we have is the older adults, which is ego integrity versus despair. If all the seven psychological crises has been resolved, now the older adult develop integrity, now the older develop or the older adult is independent and he is happy, he is self-confidence, he has found a well-defined role in the life. So Erik H. Erikson's theory is simple and comprehensive, and it is easy to understand, and actually it is based on the age-wise classification of individual, and actually we can apply this theory at each stage of our life, each stage of the development of our life, but everything comes with certain demerits. So Erikson has talked, it is based on the extreme ends of the personality, either it is positive or it is negative. So he has talked about the extreme behaviors. So this is about Erikson psychosocial theory. If you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment below. Give it a thumbs up. If you like the video, make sure you subscribe to this channel if you haven't done it yet, and I'll see you soon.